Good morning, my dear children. Once again, I welcome all of you to this economics class. Today, we'll discuss about the rest of the factors which determines the price elasticity of demand. Till third factor, we have discussed in our previous module. In this fourth factor is the proportion of total expenditure spent on the product. That is, larger the proportion of total expenditure spent on a good, higher will be the elasticity and vice versa. That means, larger the proportion of the total expenditure spent on a good, higher will be the elasticity. That means we have to spend more money for some goods. So such goods demand will be highly elastic. What happens to that? Because if the price increases or decreases, the demand also changes according to that. Because the larger the proportion that we are spending upon such goods, so a small alterations upon the changes in the prices also causes the changes in the elasticity. The next factor is the level of income. The higher the level of income, the lower the elasticity of demand and vice versa. What is that? That is, if our income is very high, the changes in the price does not affect the demand because we are having enough income or money at our disposal. So what happens? We can demand more and more commodities also. So there also the elasticity is very low. So this is also the important factor which determines the price elasticity of demand. The next one is habit, or we'll just tell it as the taste and the preferences. If you are habituated to a particular good, elasticity will be less and vice versa. That means all are having certain preferences towards certain commodities. And if we usually buy some commodities according to our taste, if it becomes a habit, that is, if you are habituated to a particular good, that increases or decreases in the prices also, less will be affected for the demand. Because according to your preferences, you are demanding such commodities. So whatever may be the changes in the prices, it does not affect its demand. That's why its elasticity is very less. The next factor is time period. What is that? During short period, most of the commodities are having less elasticity of demand. That means, in the short period means, it ranges from 6 months to 1 year. So within this time period, the whatever be the changes in the prices will be least affected in the demand also, because the customers will wait for a time period and after that only they will change according to the fluctuations in the prices. So that is the during short period, most of the commodities are having less elasticity of the demand. Suddenly, the customers won't change their demand. they will just wait for the time period, and after still the price exists in that manner, sometimes it leads to the changes in the demand. So that is, in the long run, when substitutes are available, the demand for the goods will become more elastic. So we have discussed earlier about the substitute goods. So substitute goods, in that elasticity is also very high. Why? You know that the increases in the price of the one commodity leads to the, what happened, increases in the demand for the other commodity, because the two goods perform the similar function. So that's why here the time period means, in the short run means, it is the time period, that is, it ranges from, or it varies to 6 months or to 1 year. So within that time period, these customers, suddenly they won't change their demand. They will just wait for the time period to the prices to be get again stabilized. But after a time period, that is in the long run, there is a chance of what changes in the demand, that is being more elastic. Especially in the case of substitutes also, the demand for the goods will become more elastic. So my dear children, these are the important factors which determines the elasticity of the demand for a commodity. So if we go through all these factors, we know that first is, if we analyze that one, there is the income of the consumers, as well as the time period, as well as the taste and preferences of the consumers, isn't it? So all these factors affects the price elasticity of the demand. So I hope this session related to the factors affecting the demand for a commodity is very clear for you. Thank you, children, for watching this video.